Hi, my name is James Pitts, and I'm the Application Technology Manager here at BSF 3D Printing Solutions. Today with this metal tutorial, we're going to show you how to make your process as smooth as possible for using our metal filaments. So why do we need metal filaments? So this process opens up the barrier to manufacturing for you and your teams. The traditional CNC or powder bed or laser processes are very, very interesting and very effective, however, very cost prohibitive. This process that we're going to provide to you has an order of magnitude reduction in printer cost. Everything from a prosumer level to even a hobby level printer will work with our filaments. These are fused filament fabrication printers. So what are our customers and ourselves using this material for? Well, we're using it in jigs and fixtures, small series prototypes, and basically replication of metal parts in situations that either were too cost effective or time requirements. So there's very little lead time. We don't have a mold to make. We don't have tools to buy. We have a printer. Once you have a printing solution, you print it. Once it's printed, debound, and sintered, and you have a metal part. So how does this system work? Well, fundamentally, you take a metal powder and you combine it with a binder. That binder is used to make the filaments used for FFF or fused filament fabrication printing. That's everything from a prosumer to a hobby to an industrial machine. That filament is used to make our green parts, which we're going to talk about later in the process. That part, such as this, is a green part that is taken to a process called catalytic debinding. Now, catalytic debinding was developed for the metal injection industry, very similar to plastic injection mold, except the final part is metal like ours are. Those parts are then debound, removing the binders, removing the polymers, leaving the metal part to be sintered in an oven and having a full metal part at the end. So let's take a second to talk about some of the advantages of metal FFF. One of them is usability. With a large number of videos on YouTube, with a very vibrant hobby community, FFF is one of the most easy, relatively inexpensive ways to make parts. We're now transitioning this ease of use into the metal world, which compared to the dramatic reduction in capital investments required for a metal 3D printer, were orders of magnitude less expensive. So instead of paying $500,000 to get a part like this, you're paying a prosumer or hobby machine. Another thing is hollow and light structures. FFF is uniquely positioned to make hollow, truly hollow structures. So imagine you want your part to be lighter. You want it to be easier to use or the car to take less gasoline, right? You make it light. Well, this enables us to make with infill structures to make light features. Those features have exactly what it sounds like. There's no material inside there. This cannot be easily replicated with other powder or laser-based systems because you physically have to get the powder out of the part when you're done. By not having any of that, by using our binder system and FFF delivery method, you don't have to design around getting that out. So you can realize significant reductions in mass of your part, and that only benefits both the printing and use and the cost to operate your parts that you're producing in the final place. Another thing is post-processing. Because of the nature of the green part, you can easily sand, drill, add features to it. You can really kind of be a craftsperson and work the material before it's finalized in the metal. Before you have to wait and for it to be redone over and over again, you can actually sand it or treat it or things like that. Now we're gonna talk about how to get this product working for you. We have two models right now. Currently, there'd be the DIY method, which would be buying the filament from one of our providers. You would take it, print it at either your home or your office, and then send it to one of our debinding and sintering networks to go ahead and be processed, and you would return with a metal part. Second option is using the Sculpteo platform, where you would submit a solid model, and within 3 weeks, return to you a metal part. And this way, you can realize small series production, or even try before you buy. In the following sections of this video, we're going to talk about the various steps in the process flow, everything from printing up to simulation, debinding and sintering, and everything you need to make it as smooth as possible.